Yo, check it out. This is Ice-T, and I'm gonna be on LoveLine coming up next. Don't touch that dial.
LoveLine is meant for an adult audience. LoveLine may contain sexually oriented content.
LoveLine. Viewer discretion advised.
This is my partner, Dr. Drew. He's a board-certified physician. He's addiction medicine specialist. Drew, how are you?
I'm fine. How are you?
Good. Ready to go?
I am.
All right. Tonight, our guest. This man is a movie star. He's a star of TV, a rap, rock. He's a philosopher, a philanthropist, a pimp sometimes. He does it all. Ladies and gentlemen, our guest is Ice-T. We'll be talking to our good friend Chris Magaha. Hi, Chris.
Yeah, so I was thinking the back of the show. I mean, you could. Hi, guys.
Also, we will be using the Pictel technology. It's a camera, it's a phone, it's expensive. We're using it, and it's out at Dublin's on Sunset Strip. People will be wandering in front of it and asking us questions throughout the night.
Great.
All right, ready to get started?
I really am. Let's go.
Let's talk to Josh on the phone. Josh?
Yeah. Okay, my question is, whenever I'm doing something inactive, like sitting in a classroom or driving or something like that, and I have a really, really big yawn, right after I'm done yawning, I'll get an erection. And I won't even be thinking about anything sexual. So I just wanted to find out if, you know what causes
it? Sure. Hey, you're bored. Why not get a boner? That's what that is.
Well, I just want to know, is it normal, or am I just a freak? I mean...
It's not that you're a freak, and it's not as though everybody experiences that, so it's not what you would qualify as normal or average, but it's not a medical problem. It's just part of the...
Well, I knew it wasn't a medical problem, but I mean...
I don't get smart with the doctor, John. He'll loosen that tie up and kick a little ass, believe me.
I know. So do you have any idea what causes this?
Where is he?
Yeah, listen, are you at the tuberculosis ward at the hospital? What's going on back there? Yawning causes it. Why? I have a theory.
Why?
I just said that hoping it would lead me into a theory. I think you yawn, you loosen up the jaw muscles, the chest muscles then begin to constrict, and it pulls the penis up toward your chin.
I'm not sure that's it, but... It has something to do with the change in the what's called the autonomic tone and the vascular permeability of the pelvic region. It sneezing, yawning, these are all very similar kinds of mechanisms, and so it's natural enough that these things could be connected. It's not a problem. It's something that wouldn't be written about in the medical journals because it's not really an issue.
All right, you're fine, Josh.
Okay, yeah. Josh?
Yes, close your mouth and continue driving. All right, he's got a pay-per-view coming out. He's got a website out. He's got a body count CD coming out in March. Ladies and gentlemen, Ice-T. Good to see you again, Ice. It's been so long.
Last night.
He doesn't mean that in a sexual way either. He did the radio show last night. Now, last night, of course, we're talking about, well, what do you want to talk about? You want to talk about body count? You want to talk about the website or the pay-per-view?
All of it. Let's talk about all of it.
Why don't we start with the pay-per-view?
Pay-per-view is called Ice-T's Extreme Babes, and it's a show we just came up with because, like, when I travel all over the world, I always run into all these women that want to get into the business, so I immediately ask them, do they have a problem taking their clothes off? And when they say no, we put them on our show. So if you watch the pay-per-view, basically it's 10 butt-naked women dancing around.
It's really...
real simple.
Yes. Yeah, you get right to it. You know what people want. Here's what they want in a pay-per-view. They don't want to see a guy getting his head bashed in or a woman strutting around naked.
And then you get to vote. You get to vote and figure out which one of these women is the best, and then she competes next week against the winners.
Right.
But these are all women that I just found on the street. Like, if I'm riding home tonight and if I see a girl in the corner, I'll jump out and I'll say, you want to get naked on television? And most of them say, yeah. So I never, we'll be on forever.
I'm guessing it would be a different answer if I asked the same question. I'd rather get like a handbag across my face. But
that's Ice-T's Extreme Babes.
It's $5.95.
Cheap.
It's the best five. Come on, you spend $45 to see Tyson breathe on McNeely and have him tip over.
Especially for the guys out there that know how to, are really in touch with themselves, you can turn this into an exciting night.
And I think you know what ICE means. All right, ICE, help us out with some of these calls, and we'll get to some of your many other projects as we go on. Chris, who do you have for us?
Here at our luscious LoveLine phone booth with Steve, and he's got a question for you.
Yeah, I have a question about, I like to suck on my girlfriend's breast, and I leave her bruises sometimes, and I've been told from my mom that that can develop into cancer of the bruises. Is that true, or she just doesn't want me sucking my girlfriend's breast?
It is.
Steve, as a woman, I'm going to tell you to quit sucking so hard, first of all.
And it's
what
not...
don't you talk about with your mother? That's. My God.
Is that him right there in that booth right
That's
there?
That's him.
does not have anything to do with cancer. Nothing, okay?
It's like a hickey, right?
It's like a hickey.
It's a booby.
But, boy.
No, but I don't tell my mom that. It's just, I used to play rough with my sister. I used to hit her there, and she told me don't hit her there because that can, you know, give her assist and develop.
Well, hitting and sucking too, is a little different.
And that, too, was an old wives' tale. That really doesn't have anything
watch
to do
with it. Watch your pay-per-view. You'll learn the difference between the hicking and the hitting and the sucking. There's a whole half hour devoted to that.
Steve, nothing to do with breast cancer, okay?
All right, Steve.
Thank you, Steve.
Vanessa on the LoveLine phone. What's your question?
Hi. I've been with my boyfriend since I was 15, and I've had no other sexual partners, and I have been checked out, and I have no STDs. My problem is I'm starting to smell like 1,200 hobos down there, and I've been making excuses not to have sex with them for the past 5 months.
Like 1,200 what?
Hobos.
So I need to know what I can do.
All right, Vanessa,
about the smell.
That is a vaginal infection. It is not necessarily sexually transmitted. You should see the doctor about it. There's a medicine called Flagyl and Metronidazole. There's even Metrogel cream.
As soon as I started smelling like 500 or 600 hobos, that's when I go to the gynecologist.
It is possible that your boyfriend brought something into the relationship, I suppose. But this kind of...
Well, no, I know he hasn't been with anybody.
Douche will not clear it up. It requires... This is Gardnerella, Haemophilus, or sometimes Trichomonas that causes these smells. This is an infection of the vagina. It requires antibiotics to be treated. And you've got to see the doctor. You've got to get it taken care of, or it's not going to go away.
Well, where does it come from?
There's actually debate about where it comes from. It used to be thought of as primarily a sexually transmitted disease, but it's now believed that it can sort of occur spontaneously. These are bacteria that are probably, most of these different infections anyway, are bacteria that are always present in your vagina and just overgrow for various reasons.
It ultimately originates in hell, I believe. And then
it
moves to the vagina.
You had a baby.
Yeah,
I mean, obviously that can dramatically change the hormonal and really structural environment in there. So it's something you got to call your gynecologist about. It may be as simple as making a phone call. They may not even require you to be evaluated yet.
Okay. I bet so, when he hears what the problem is over the phone, he'll work it over the phone. You know?
Vanessa, get it taken care of. It's a medical problem. Okay?
All right, Vanessa, take care of yourself, please.
Wow.
All right, Drew, we have an email question, I believe.
We sure do. This is from Shelby. Shelby apparently works for a club that provides S&M services. Apparently it's legal. She says, I think it's a she, says, I'm clothed, quote, to some extent. Boyfriend thinks she's cheating, wants her to stop the job. Is she cheating, yes or no?
All right, we will be the judge, jury, and executioner.
And we'll talk to her on the phone.
And we will talk to her on the phone after we take a look at this Ice-T video called I Must Stand.
What? Death is death. Carter got 25 years. Nah. Spike 35 to life. Nah, don't tell me B.O.'s dead, man. I want to hear that, man. I was just with him. A proud black man.
Call us with your questions. Drew, how do they get hold of us?
Number is 213-520-LOVE. It's a 24-hour hotline. Call us at 213-520-LOVE and participate here on LoveLine.
All right, we're back with the multimedia Ice-T and Dr. Drew and myself. And when we left off, Drew just read himself an email from Shelby, who worked as a dominatrix at a club. Her boyfriend doesn't approve, but she says she's putting bread on the table, making money. Is she on the phone now?
She is. Shelby?
Hello.
Hi.
Hi.
Is that accurate?
Oh, it's more than accurate. Since I sent the email, my boyfriend told me it was either the job or him. So I told him I quit.
You quit the job?
No, I told him I quit.
Oh, right.
But you didn't, but you didn't quit.
We gotta eat, so I didn't quit.
What is, doesn't he have a job?
I just thought what you gotta, it's kind of a Cochrane-esque statement, but you gotta beat so you can eat.
Yeah.
I mean, now you're not taking your clothes off at this thing, right?
No, I don't take my clothes off.
Yeah, we've had callers
but
over.
But you're not wearing a big muumuu either, are you?
No, you know, you wear something sexy and appealing.
And this pays too good to do anything else?
Oh, yeah.
This is like people we talk to who have been exotic dancing and that sort of stuff.
Right.
Same issue.
Yeah, once you get in, you work 3 hours a night, 4 nights a week, you make, you know, $1,200 cash a week, and you're not going to become a Kelly girl, have some fat alcoholic boss yell at you, fight rush hour traffic. After Uncle Sam is done reaming you, you're left with $245 at the end of the week. I mean, who would want to do that?
And then the boyfriend, may, you know, guys meet girls in strip clubs, they get in relationships, and then suddenly they won't allow them to continue in that job anymore.
Adam. You're saying I did that? All right,
perhaps.
Big deal.
Perhaps.
Wasn't right.
Can you share with our caller? What should her...
All right, listen, here's what you guys, you need to be truthful, and I think you need to just come up, you need to come up with some compromise. Agree on a time period that you can have to work there, save some money, look for another job, but say within 4 months, you'll be out.
That'll never happen.
No.
Not an option.
Within a year and 4 months, you're going to be out.
Not an option.
Not an option.
Not an option.
Oh, what you tell her then? What'd she do? Dump the guy? Hook up with a client?
Dump him. He met you when you were doing it, and that's who he fell in love with, and you're a dominatrix, and he should just get down with it. You know, that's what you do.
Bend over and get dominated.
He needs another girl.
All right, so you're saying he should accept her for what she is?
Unless he's going to go out and get enough money so that she doesn't have to work. I mean, you know, somebody's got to... A lot of men don't necessarily like their jobs.
Right.
We don't like our jobs. It could be, you know, a square job or whatever, but we don't like it. But your woman can't say, I don't want you going to work.
Right, and who's
you
to
know,
say...
We got to get money, and she's getting money.
But
and...
it's kind of a bizarre job. She's.
Well, it wasn't bizarre when he met her. He met her.
But he didn't know she was doing it, though.
But he knew who she was.
Right,
he,
that's right.
He knew she had that in her.
You know, they need to reach some kind of compromise. I agree.
All right. So. Shelby, good luck to
get
you.
Get the money, baby.
All right, let's talk to Michelle, who's over at Dublin's using the Pictel system. Michelle?
Hey, guys, what's up?
Hey.
I just had a question. I slept with this guy about a month ago, and his balls were like, or his testicles were really squishy. And anyway, I just had like this totally foul vision of it, and it really turned me off. And he's just like, it's hollow, like there's nothing in there.
All right, you guys are laughing. It's a very serious affliction. It strikes one out of every 8 men. It's called the Nerf syndrome. And we will explore it after we take a look at another Ice-T video. I must stand.
Man, I know I can do better than this. I gotta get me a car, man. I gotta get a girl. I know I can do it out there, man. I'm finna go for it, man. I gotta get some money.
Hi, I'm Kari Warren. You're watching Loveline right here. You know, I'm an alumnus. MTV.
Why don't you put that computer to use and email us? Drew, tell them how to get us.
The email address is loveline3@aol.com. Also, you can check out the Loveline area at keyword MTV on America Online.
And while you got the computer warmed up, you can check out Ice-T's naughty little... what do you call it? It's not a chat room, is it?
Nah, it's a website.
Right.
It's www.iced.com. And it's, once again, butt-naked women. It's,
you get the feeling that if Ice-T opened a church, it would be the church of butt-naked women.
Well, I mean, you know, that's my thing, you know?
Yeah, so, right. You go for what you know. There's no problem.
So I was you know, surfing the web one day, and I was like, okay, the only things I wanted to actually see were the ill rooms. So mine has a live chat room. If you dial into it right now, it's not an actual live chat room. It's the girls are in a window, and you can punch in what you want them to do, and they'll do it. They'll spank each other, suck feet. It's fly. It's go right home.
Fascinating. We've got Michelle back at Dublin's. Yeah, Michelle.
All right, now Michelle's problem was that she was with a guy, and his nuts felt like they were filled with air.
Empty.
Had like a whoopee sack.
Can I tell her something? There's certain things in life that mean get out of the room, okay? Certain things, like that other girl who smelled like hobos, get out of the room.
Right.
These balls, get out of the room. You touch out. Don't check to see what's gonna come out later. This is bad
but
news.
But no, I think you had the sense that there was nothing.
A wiffle ball.
Nothing inside. Is that right? That there was.
Yeah, exactly.
Well, men have a.
It was just nothing.
Men reflexive response where the testes can actually go up inside the body when you go in the ocean, say, when it's 50 degrees.
Don't know nothing about that, Doc. Balls is always there.
They can actually ascend out of the testicular sac into the abdomen, and so make it seem like there's nothing in there.
Right.
Okay.
And that's for
protection.
Protection. It's like landing gear. When you get in a hostile situation, it just retracts up there. Because God knew you'd be using those later.
It's not normal.
But is that what's going on?
I suspect. I mean, that's all the sense I can make out of it.
There's no other syndrome where it's filled with, like, that peanut styrofoam packing stuff or anything like that?
No.
There's nothing like that?
No.
All right. Did anything unusual come out?
Nope.
No.
Everything looked A-okay to me.
All right. Well, then it's fine. He just says, like, you know, some of the lowrider guys, they have the hydraulic. They should have some of the same competition. I don't know if you've been to these things, but they put a calibrated bar and the guys jump. They just have the thing right under the guy's lap. See, I don't know what the trophy would look like, but okay.
All right.
All right. I just had enough of me now. Drayden.
Braden.
Oh, Braden, I'm sorry.
It's a video.
All right, smart guy.
Hi, Dr. Drew. Hi, Adam. My name's Braden. I'm from Glendale. And I was wondering, you know, my girlfriend performs oral sex on me, and she swallows. But the rest of the night, she has passing gas all night long. And I was wondering if I have gassy sperm or, you know, what might be the problem?
You know, that is a first. I thought we have heard it all.
Hey, go for the gas, man. Let her fart all night. That's cool. As long as you keep swallowing, man, just deal with it, baby.
It's like a...
It's like a swallow or a fart. I take it.
What's that? And it's like smelling yourself being recycled, though.
But usually, I mean, you're sleepy anyway, so you could probably, like, roll over and... throw the pillow up, and she can fart the rest of the night. Who cares?
Now, here's the real question. If she breaks wind and then her sister walks in the room, can she get pregnant? Think about that. Drew, any reason why that may cause some sort of disturbance in the intestines or anything like that?
No.
No.
I mean, you guys...
All right, let's move on then. He's all right.
Please.
She's all right.
Everything's
crack
fine.
The window and keep going. Steve, it's on the LoveLine phone.
Yeah, I have about a small build, and I want to use a steroid called Deca to bulk up. But I also hear that, you know, rumors that it shrinks your penis and testicles. And I'm kind of concerned, is it going to shrink my penis enough for my girlfriend to notice, or if I stop taking it?
It's amazing, Steve. I mean, these are very, very dangerous chemicals, right? These anabolic androgenic steroids, they cause high blood pressure, stroke, heart disease, enlargement of the heart, kidney disease, liver disease. We know this. We know it can only make you sick. Yes, it will make you bulk up. Yes, it will make you stronger. But it's going to be deleterious for your system in general. Now that I've said all that, he doesn't care. However, if we tell him that his testicles are going to shrink, that somehow...
Don't do anything that will ever make your penis get smaller. Nothing.
It's amazing to me how I can say categorically that you are likely to become physically ill and you could shorten your life expectancy. You could kill you.
Drew, yeah.
Doesn't matter.
Drew can say...
Just don't shrink it, boy.
You take steroids, your spine will fall out, it will run across the room and dry hump your girlfriend, and the guys would say, all right, I knew there'd be some drawbacks, but as soon as you go to the penis, that's what people hear.
It's
that's
just amazing.
What they respond
just
to.
Just amazing. So it really doesn't shrink the penis. It actually, guys experience accelerated sexual activity initially, then the testes shrink, the sperm production goes down, and then there's increasing difficulty performing sexually. And then when you come off the steroids, it can be permanently difficult. I've seen guys who can no longer attain a regular erection and who have fertility problems the rest of their life.
And then all you got is big arms.
Well, right. And even those go away when
to do with
when you
them.
Stop doing the steroids.
You'll have something to do with them, but...
But it ain't gonna work. All right, so Steve, it ain't worth it.
It can only hurt you, that's all. Be careful, please,
all right.
Okay?
All right. Joe on the LoveLine phone, what's your question for us tonight?
Yeah, here's the situation. For the past year and a half, my penis has been curving to the left and up. I read in a men's health magazine that there's something called Peyronie disease, which is where the penis gets injured and develops scar tissue.
Correct.
I was wondering if this is what I have, or how do I get rid of it? Or
almost any curvature can be Peyronie's disease. So Peyronie just means a curvature, basically, and it's caused by a scarring on one side that pulls it over towards the scar. There are operations that will get rid of it. The more definitive operations tend to shorten the penis a little bit. So typically, you wouldn't do anything with this unless you're having pain with erection or erectile dysfunction of some kind.
Did you injure yourself, Joe?
I really don't know. It could have been like during sex or something.
If it curves the right way, though, you can hit the G spot.
That's right.
Yeah.
If it's really Peyronie's, it'll tend to get worse and tend to be associated with dysfunction. At this stage.
Who is this man, Peyronie? Is this the guy with the world's most crooked penis?
I don't know. Same guy where he was the urologist that described it originally or something.
Oh, okay.
So it functions properly. It's just like if I pull back too far, it pops out, and I gotta like reposition it again and stuff.
Look, that I don't care if your penis is straight as an arrow. You gotta that's gonna happen.
Yeah, Joe. As long as you're not having any real symptoms, I would kind of leave well enough alone. Okay.
You think so?
Yes.
Yeah.
Just amazing how much guys preoccupy about this stuff. Really, it's phenomenal.
Johnny's on the LoveLine phone. Johnny.
Yeah, the past month, I've been starting to fart all the time, like 30 times a day and stuff. And I'm not taking any medication, and my diet's the same. And but around girls and stuff, you know, I hold it in, but during sex, you know, when I climax, I really let loose sometimes.
Oh.
Hey, we got a girl to hook you up with.
That's right. There'd be one big ball of spermy gas in that room. All right, Johnny, much to Drew's dismay, we will tackle this right after we take a look at Got a Lot of Love from Ice-T.
Chill, Crips and Bloods holding hands, admit it's ill, but I love it. I can't help it. Too much depth on the streets and we dealt it. Van S boys, the Hoovers, the 60s, bounty hunters, 8-Trade, all cooling out, G. I pray that this'll never stop. You used to see the wrong colors in the gaps when pop, pop. But now the kids got a chance to live. And the OG's got something to give. That's love, black on black.
You can videotape your questions and send them to us, Drew.
That's right. Don't send them to Ice-T Extreme Babe. Send them to us. LoveLine 1040 North Las Palmas. First Avenue, Hollywood, California, 90038.
Dr. Drew, and when we left off, we're speaking to Johnny on the LoveLine phone. Johnny has a little, what I call the nerve gas. I have not talked about this in a long time. He gets gassy when he's out with the women, and it's because you have the nerves going. There's the anticipation. Will there be sex? Will there not be sex?
I don't know about that.
Huh?
I don't know about that, because I know there will be.
Oh, you do?
Yeah.
Oh, you have you like
oh,
that.
Oh, you're so silky smooth that you got to break wind every time you're around a woman, don't you, Johnny?
Now, I know that under nervous situations, it will go down like that, because back in the days when I used to be doing the wrong thing, you get a carload full of four guys, if they are on their way to do something illegal, the car starts smelling, everybody, you start, the nerves, people get
you
scared.
You got a drive-by farting going on.
Yeah. I ain't say no drive-by, but I'm just saying it's like...
Well, you couldn't
people
do
get
it.
Nervous.
Had to
people
get, out
get
of the
nervous.
Car. Johnny.
Yeah.
All right. So you only fart when you're having sex?
No, I fart all the time. But then when I'm having sex, I can't hold it in. I mean, but sometimes you know when I climax, you know you get all, and then you just let it loose.
Right.
And I just want to know how I can control it because some of the girls aren't appreciating that very much.
Understatement.
All right. You will not be able to control it because that is a time when you're out of control. Your body is taking over and it's doing what it wants. And if stuff's coming out the front and out at the back at the same time,
yep.
That's just your body. But you can do what I do. I hate to give away this secret, but I'm telling you, this works. I'm not kidding. I'm dead serious. If you can time clearing your throat with the breakage of the wind, nobody knows. You could stand in a crowded elevator and go, and if you break wind right as you do the hum, nobody except whoever's behind you notices.
Well, what if she's down there and she can smell it?
Oh, yeah, all right. You got to get a fan happening then. All right, Drew, what is there? Some Beano. What is the medication he can take? Drew, this is a physical problem.
I'm trying to address it as such. Watch your diet, spices. You are going to have to find out what those things are in your diet that cause the bacteria flora of your gut to produce the methane. There is going to be something that generates this. Indeed, nerve can do it. Increased bulk in your diet. Less spicy foods. Some people, less of the legumes, less of the beans. Things like Beano, things like Metamucil. The charcoals, there are things out there you can experiment with that might help
charcoal.
You. But there is no consistently systematic way that people can take care of this problem
methane.
Necessarily. I would say the diet is the first thing to look at very, very carefully, though. Okay?
Okay.
All right, Johnny. Lisa on the LoveLine phone. What's your question, Lisa?
Yeah, hi. I've been offered up to $2,000 an hour for sex. So I'm thinking about becoming a call girl. My question is if I should tell my family because I'm really close to them and I don't like keeping secrets.
Wow.
Who's that?
There's some secrets you gotta keep, Lisa. One is I'm gonna be a call girl.
Nice. What kind of advice would you give somebody who's thinking about this kind of lifestyle?
Oh, are you serious? I mean, have you ever done it before?
I've done it once before.
And you didn't have a problem with it?
Not really. I got quite a bit of money for that 1 hour.
Who's offering you?
You really got me twisted on television because I don't want to get arrested for pandering right here on television. But I think I'm just going to get out of this conversation right quick. But I got a TV show and a website.
Lisa, who offered you the money?
This one guy, he's a doctor.
He's a physician?
Yeah.
His name.
2 G's is good, though.
No.
That's a lot of money. $100.
Was he your doctor?
No.
And he offered you $2,000 to have sex?
I did get $2,000 for it.
Lisa, how did you feel? How did that make you feel about yourself?
It doesn't make me feel real good about myself.
Yeah.
But
if you get really into this, it's going to be a cycle down. I mean, you're going to be trapped because of the money. You're going to be have increasing feelings of self-worthlessness. Were you abused when you were younger? Do you already feel bad about yourself?
Yes, I was abused when I was younger, and I haven't been with my family for a long time.
I mean, Lisa, it's people that have been through those sorts of events in childhood that choose to do this sort of thing in adulthood, and it's the victimizers that can pick up on. I'm sorry, I said I'm going to hear a victimizer, but
yes, you
but,
do.
But you know what? That guy, the physician, is a criminal in my mind. He's a victimizer, and he sensed that you were a good victim, and he took advantage of it. I mean, this is going to add to your feelings of self-worthlessness. It's going to create a spiral downward. If you want to feel better about yourself, don't go down this path. Get some help for yourself. Deal with the issues generated from having been abused. Don't go down this path.
Yeah, let me become politically correct for a minute.
But don't do it. Don't be politically correct.
I'm gonna be honest.
Be empathic towards
it. I got the two ITs right here, right? I got the one that says, come hook up with me and let's... But then I got the other one that's going to tell you the right thing to do right now. Stay away. Once you take money for it, then you're going to make the transformation into it. And it's not always going to be $2,000. It's going to end up being $10 sooner or later. And if you connect with the wrong guy, you're going to be in trouble. And just don't do it for money no matter what. I just lost my pimp card for life. But
You're lucky, sir. Wow. I mean, that side of you that says don't do it. I mean, think about that person, you know?
Yeah, I know, I understand. I'm trying to rehabilitate. I'm trying to make myself better, right?
All right, okay. But meanwhile, the pimp card has been revoked.
True. Yeah, I know you're disappointed at it, but, you know.
Perhaps I could take over the pimp card in your absence. All right, Chris, who do you have for us over there?
I'm up here at our cappuccino bar with Elizabeth, and she's got a question for you.
I met a guy over the internet a while ago, and we started out having cyber sex, which led to phone sex, both of which I was really into. Since then, we decided to go out on a couple of dates, but whenever the time comes for us to be intimate, I'm just unable to do it, and I'm sort of wondering why am I not able to feel the same level of intimacy and closeness that I felt with him before in the real world.
Because before, he was just a fantasy. He was something of your own creation. He wasn't a real person. You didn't have a real relationship with him. It was all in your mind. Now you're confronted with a real person.
He was over 5 feet and under 300 pounds before.
Still is.
Now it's kind of like the scariness and the realness of it, don't you think, Drew?
Yeah, I mean, it's there's a separate real person there that you have to contend with, not just the idealized person you created in your mind.
Okay.
It can be very disappointing and very, very difficult to reconcile those two people. I mean, in your mind, you had all this closeness and maybe you were even falling in love with this person on the internet. That's not him. That's you. That's your idealized creation. That's not a relationship.
Okay.
It's like we've created this society of Dr. Frankensteins with the computer. Right. Everyone is like building the perfect girlfriend or building the perfect boyfriend, and it's all just coming through the internet, coming through the computer. But there does come a time when you actually have to meet somebody. You have to smell their breath. You have to thump them a little like a melon if you're like me to find out what's in them, and you have to find out that they're human.
Well, a lot of times, even like on the phone, like if you meet somebody quick and then get on the phone, and you could be on a phone conversation like for a long time. And you know, I mean like months maybe, because you don't have a chance to see them. And then the phone relationship will build way up. I mean, you guys could be having phone sex and stuff like that. But then when you actually meet them, it's almost like you gotta start all over again. You can't just jump in from the point of the phone conversation.
Right.
It's kind of like different. It's like you were talking all that stuff on the phone, you know, but now it's like, but there you go though, you know. It's a little scary, it's kind of normal.
All right, so what's the advice, Drew?
The advice is don't be surprised that you're having trouble with this relationship. It may not be what you hope it to be, and if it isn't, be realistic about it and either terminate it, give it a good college try, and if it doesn't work out, it doesn't work out.
Or respect cyber love as what it is and real love, separate them.
Right.
You know, separate them. Say, this is what I do in cyberspace, and this is reality. When you try to connect them,
right. Give them. That's why it's called fantasy. Thanks, Elizabeth. Lisa on the Loveline phone.
Hi, this question is basically for Dr. Drew. Dr. Drew, when I was 15, I had a breast reduction, and now I'm 20. And just the day before yesterday, I had my second one.
I'm sorry, what?
Breast reduction.
Breast reduction at 15.
Yeah, I'm 20 now, and I just had my second one.
Okay. They did the right one this time? It's a little breast comedy, really. Okay.
Well, and I wanted to know, I have, I guess, two questions. A, how common is it for them to grow back? And B, the sensitivity went down the first time, and I know it's going to go down the second time. Is there anything I can do to, like, try and build up that sensitivity? And I guess, C, one more, I'm planning on losing weight, and will that affect my breath in any way?
Okay. All right. These are all things I know. You should be asking me these questions. I've done I could open a research center for breasts. I've done that type of extensive research, Drew. And we will get to this after we take a look at I Ain't New to This by Steve.
Step to me, you catch a left and a right fist. Boom, bang, I drop that slang. When I used to hustle, used to be down with the crack game. When I was young, we used to roll with the street gang. If you want to squabble, homeboy, it ain't no thing. I ain't new to this, I ain't new to this. Blow your dome, I hit quick as a pugilist. Boom, I'm what's up.
You've got questions, we've got answers. Drew, how do they get hold of us?
They can just call us at 213-520-LOVE, 213-520-LOVE.
All right, we're back with Ice-T. Got some more Loveline to go. When we left off, we were speaking to Lisa on the phone. Lisa had a breast reduction.
At 15.
At 15, she had another one, or lost a little sensitivity. Now she's 20. She needs another one.
You've already had it, or you need another one?
I had it on Wednesday.
Had it already. You okay?
Yeah, I'm recovering, yeah.
Yeah.
What, all right, but you realize I have to ask, so yeah. Don't bear with me.
And your research center doesn't have all the answers?
I could go run her name, but I just prefer to do it now. What size were you when you were 15?
A 38 double D.
Damn! And what'd they bring you down to?
The first time, a C.
Oh, no greater crime against society and humanity, Drew. And then you, by the time you're 20, you went back up to what?
A 36 double D.
And now what are you back down to?
Hopefully a C.
And are you overweight?
No, not that much, no.
The breast is mostly fat tissue, so if you lose weight, you will certainly lose some size there. Is that something that your doctor has counseled you on?
Well, yeah, because I had lost weight before. I went down to a size 6, but my breast, instead of going down, actually grew.
They kept going.
Really?
And obviously, if you know...
That is a message from God.
But it's certainly... at your age, when the regrowth is more likely to occur, it's actually a very unusual thing to happen. But I'm sure it'll be taken care of at this point. Well, it must be very difficult for you.
Yeah, it is.
Your boyfriend must be having a hard time, too, with those beautiful, big, voluptuous breasts in front of him.
Correct me if I'm wrong, Lisa. I mean, one of the most troubling things for you is that the guys tend to sort of deal with you as that rather than as the person, Lisa. Is that right?
Yeah.
Yeah. What made you decide to have the reductions?
The first time,
let's say.
I just had a lot of pain. So back, they were going in anyway.
Back pain, neck pain, that sort of thing?
Yeah, and this. So they were going in anyway.
Most people that have the reductions done are doing it because of medical reasons. They get a lot of neck pain, shoulder pain. The posture gets bad. And women, when they get this done, usually are very satisfied, very happy with the procedure. Were you happy the first time around?
Oh, yeah. It changed my life. Yeah. It really saved my life.
Good, all right, so. It ruined everyone else's life, but your life is fine now.
Chris, do you have anything for Lisa?
Yeah, don't listen to Adam. Whatever you do, just don't listen to Adam. There's guys out there that'll really love you for you. And just really start working on yourself.
Hey, can I have her fired?
You know, just really concentrate on yourself and really, you know.
All right. All
do
right,
that. Don't listen to Adam. There's a lot of guys out there who'll love you for you.
All right, Lisa, thank you. Jeremy.
Yeah, hey.
Hey.
I've been with a lot of girls, but I'm still a virgin, and that's actually by choice, but one thing that I really want but can't seem to get is oral sex, and my roommates tease me because they've received oral sex from girls that I've dated, and my question is... Yeah, that kind of...
That'll get
cool.
You teased.
And my question is, what exactly am I doing wrong?
Was it while you're on the date?
No, not... I don't know, I'm just wondering
Jeremy, why don't you take care of the bill so I can take care of your friend? No, nothing like that.
No.
Okay.
No, but I'm just wondering, what am I doing wrong, or if I need to be more aggressive or actually ask for oral sex, or what?
Yeah, I will get something signed before I go out on a date. That might we ask for oral sex.
What are you looking at me for? Why
you know?
What? How do you have oral sex without actually having intercourse?
No, well, he wants to know.
He
how
said
to
he
get
doesn't want. He wants to stay a virgin, though.
But he wants to get the oral sex.
Yeah.
Give her some oral
sex. All my friends make fun of me because I haven't had it yet, and I kind of like to have it because it sounds pretty cool.
Give the woman some oral sex.
I have.
And they still didn't do it?
No, she gave
oral sex to my roommate.
Oh, you got to get mad at that
point. That's when you got to put your foot down, man. It's not the same equivalent. You know, some girls say, well, if you took me out to dinner, I don't owe you something. Okay, I agree. If I take you out to dinner, but if I perform something on you like that, we're going to have a discussion later.
Yeah.
Going to be some serious talking.
All right, Jeremy, there's no magic answer. Believe me, if I knew the words that could get oral sex, I wouldn't be wasting my time sitting here right now.
But don't be afraid to ask. Don't be afraid to ask, especially if you've committed yourself sexually with her like that.
Okay.
Ask. Say, why don't you want to do it?
But don't
just
do
come
it.
Come out and ask.
Do it when you're...
Yeah, just come out and ask.
Do it, yeah, but after you help her.
No, ask her first, man. You're getting gypped already. You're getting gypped. You have the right to say, I've already done that before and it didn't happen for me. Now, we're going to have to make an agreement. Get a prenuptial.
All right, Jeremy. Ice, thank you very much for showing up tonight. We do appreciate it. He's got himself Body Count's got a CD coming out in March. He's got the website. He's got the pay-per-view. He's got it all going on. Chris McGaha, thank you very much tonight. And until next time, this is Adam Carolla for Dr. Drew. Say mahalo.
Introducing Durasteel by Armatron. Steel cases, bracelets, superb quality and outstanding value. The toughest and best looking watch. Armatron Durasteel, a state of mind and body. Aroma Vera's aromatic gift crates. Indulge in the pure enjoyment of essential oil-based personal care products designed to enhance the beauty of daily life. From Aroma Vera. Tommy Tang's, LA's restaurant to the entertainment industry. A gift package of his personalized line of seasonings and sauces, best-selling cookbook, and chef's wear from Tommy Tang's.